Hare Krishna. Om Agyanati Vrandasya Jnanan Jana Shalakaya Chakshuram Militam Yena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Shri Chaitanya Manobhisham Sapitam Yena Bhutale Swayam Rupah Kadamayam Dharati Svapadantikam Vanchaha Kalpataru Bhyasya Kripa Sindhu Bhyayevacha Patitana Bhavane Bhyo Vaishave Bhyo Namo Namaha Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Srivasadi Gaur Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare 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 Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So this is the island of Navadwip, and each island represents a specific limb of bhakti, and Navadwip represents smarana. So it's not just enough to chant Hare Krishna Maha Mantra here. You have to also chant Gauranga! 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 So my mercy of the Panchatattva, Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda, Sri Advaita Gadadhar Shivasari Gaur Bhakta Vrinda, and all the devotees of Gauranga Mahaprabhu Gaur Parshad, and all the devotees in the line of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, we get the opportunity to serve the Dham, come here and hear and chant the glories of the Lord. So this is a very, very important place, Pushkar, in the Madhyadweep. And Madhyadweep represents Smaranam. So I'm going to speak about Smaranam. So Smaranam, just now, is only in a Bhakti, Manmali Maharaj. He is quoting a lot of verses from Bhagavad Gita. So in the Bhagavad Gita, the 8th chapter, the chapter which represents the art of dying. So in that chapter, Krishna says, Yambyam vapi smarana bhavam tyajate ante kalevaram tam tamaiveti konteya sada tad bhava bhavita. So the end, at the end of the life, it's not so easy to remember the Lord, is it not? Even now it's very difficult to remember the Lord. What about at the end of the life? That's why King Kulakshetra in the Mukundamala Stotra, it's a very famous book, and initially Srila Prabhupada started the translation and commentary for the few verses, but later on it was completed by Srila Saswara Das Goswami Maharaj. And very nice book, a lot of prayers, very nice prayers. And one of the prayers Srila Prabhupada should sing quite often. Krishna todiya pada pankaja pancharanta madvaiva me visato manasa raja hamsaha prana prayana samaye kafavata pittai kanthavrodhonovidhosvarnamkutasthi. So the Ayurveda explains that our body is made of three elements specifically, the bile, mucus and air, kaph, vat and pit. And if there is imbalance in these three elements, then we become sick, is it not? So yeah, so the end of the life, there is so much imbalance in kaph, vat and pit, bile, mucus and air. And that really disturbs our consciousness and really disturbs our concentration. And the whole body is in a very big trouble, you know. So, kaph, vat, pit and bile, mucus and air. So, King Kulakshetra is saying, kantha avrodhono. And this bile and mucus and air, because of imbalance, and the throat is choked up. You can't speak. It's not easy to chant Hare Krishna at the end of life. It only can happen by the mercy. Yeah. So how does mercy come? So mercy comes, somebody has done something. It's not a wonderful affair. We can't quoting Ajamil. At the end of the life, he was able to remember the Lord, not remember the Lord exactly. He was trying to call his son Narayan. And when he called Narayan, what happened? Vishuddhutas came. So that is the potency of the holy name. But that generally doesn't happen. Ajamil's case, Vishwanath Thakur says, it's an exceptional case, is it not? So most of us will have to undergo the process of bhakti, follow the process of bhakti. And so there is one another verse similar to this. I don't remember the verse exactly. It's either in Vayu Puran or Agni Puran. And this prayer by King Kulukshetra is being answered in that particular scripture. What King Kulukshetra, what is his worry? He's saying it's very, very difficult to remember the Lord at the end of the life. Now I'm healthy. I can remember you, Lord, the Lord now. It is easy to focus my mind, the lotus feet of the Lord. But at the end of life, my throat will be choked up with bile mucus air. It will be very, very difficult to remember you, Lord. So just like he gives the example of flamingo, you know, flamingo. Flamingo or the swan. It tries to enter the stem of the lotus flower, you know. And it circles around the stem of the lotus. And so the flamingo likes that, you know. So similarly, the feet of the Lord is compared to the lotus. And the mind, my mind is like the flamingo. Why it's like flamingo? Why it is like swan? Why? Because my mind keeps on flickering. The flamingo is very, very flickering, very, very, you can say, he always keeps on moving. It's not stable, you know. Very unsteady. And similarly, my mind is also like that. Chanchalam hi mana krishna balava pramati balava dhridam. So my mind is also very, very flickering. So my prayer is that, please, at least I'm healthy. So now, please be merciful on me so that I can focus this mind on your lotus feet. It is easy to remember now. Because later on it will be very, very difficult, almost impossible. So this is a prayer by King Kulukshetra. But in this another Puran, either in Vayu Puran or Agni Puran somewhere. So it's mentioned there, the devotees, they don't have to worry about this. The Lord is saying somebody has actually done a lot of hearing and chanting, have been serving me throughout the whole life. At the end of life, it may happen. His throat may be choked up with kaph, vata and with bile, mucus and air. It will be very, very difficult for him to remember me. So what the Lord will do? You have been serving the Lord whole life. So there is a reciprocation, is it not? It is not when you have a darshan of deities in the temple and the deities are just standing. We are chanting every day. We are going to the Mangalarti and doing a lot of kirtan there, chanting our rounds, praying to the Lord. But nothing is happening. Deities are not moving at all. No expression, no feeling, no reciprocation. And this we have been doing for years together. Especially those who are the neophytes, they say they are struggling a lot. We are all struggling. So very, very difficult, you know. There is no expression, no reciprocation, is it not? So that is why we keep on moving. As soon as we all pay obeisances, we get up and just we move fast. We don't even stay before the deities for a long time. So it is very difficult. So like that, you know. So it's very, very difficult to remember the Lord like that. And because there is no exchange. There is no exchange of feelings. So sometimes, you know, it's very bewildering, you know. I have been chanting for so many years, having darshan every day of the deities and nothing is happening and no reciprocation. He doesn't even talk to me, no lip movements, no expression of eyes. What is this? He's just standing and playing flute and I can't even hear the sound of the flute. Nothing is happening. And I've been told to go for the Mangalarti every day and have the darshan of the Lord. And this keeps on happening for years together. But we should not get discouraged because the Lord is watching. Utsa nishya dhairya. That's why Srila Rupa Goswami is saying, Utsa nishya dhairya tat tat karma pravartana sangatyaga satoprite shadhir bhakti prasidhyati. So at the end of the life, when we have enthusiasm, patience and determination and we keep on following the process of bhakti, what will happen? At the end of the life, the Lord, that is the test. At the end of life, we will be tested very, very severely. And that test is what? Whether we have followed the process of bhakti seriously or not. And if you have followed the process of bhakti seriously, then what will happen? Krishna says in Bhagavad Gita, there is a confirmation by the Lord. Ananya shintayanto maam ye jana pariyupasate te sham nitya viyuktanam yogakshama bahamiham. Whatever we are lacking at the end of the life, that will be preserved, that will be covered by the Lord. Whatever you are lacking in the following the process of bhakti. Suppose you have been following the process of bhakti very seriously. Even Vishwanath Thakur says in the Madhuri Gadamani, if somebody has been following the process of bhakti very seriously throughout the whole life, at the end of the life, he becomes very unhealthy, very sick. He is not able to do so much as before. So what happens is, by the power of the bhakti, whatever is left, whatever is lacking, that will be completed by the Lord. That is the meaning of Yoga Kshema Mahamayam. So that is why Krishna says, whatever we have done, that will preserve the Lord, and whatever you are lacking, He will provide. So that, what will He provide? This is what He will provide. So the Lord says in the Quran that I will give the strength, I will give the power to remember me. So we can remember the Lord only when He is remembering us. So it is not easy. It will be, so that's what. So when the Lord remembers us, it will be very easy to remember Him. So the Lord has to bestow the mercy, and He bestows the mercy to the disciplic succession, and that mercy comes through the Guru Parampara. So that's why we have to be very, very serious in following the process of bhakti. Let us not get discouraged. Oh, we have been following this process of Vaidhi bhakti so many years and nothing is happening. We hear a lot about Raganuga bhakti and all those things, Raganuga, Sadhana bhakti. And for me, it's a dream, because I'm struggling to chant the rounds and struggling to follow the regularity principles, struggling to follow the morning sadhana and my daily schedule. It's very, very difficult for me for years together, is it not? 1 year, 2 years, 3 years is okay, I can do that. But whole life, I have to do that till the end of the life. It is not so easy. So, in the beginning we may say, chant Hare Krishna and be happy. Yeah, we are, of course, very happy. And even in the beginning stage of spiritual life, we become happy. But that happiness is not just enough, we have to become more happy. So we want to become more happy, we have to continue the process of devotional service. Smaranam is very, very important, limb of bhakti. And how this smaran, how we read the stream of smaran? See, according to Srila Rupa Goswami, when he talks about the process of bhakti, when he says that adau shraddha tatha sadhu sangha tham bhajan kriya tatha anartha divirti syat tato nishtha tatha asakti tatha ruchi tato nishtha tato ruchi tatha asakti. So after, so that's all. But Srila Rupa Goswami is very, very clear. He says that pradur bhava ayam premnaha sarakanam. He says it is not a quick process, so quick. It is what? It is a gradual process. Shraddha ratir bhaktir anukramashati. Srimad Bhagavatam also says, it's a gradual process. We cannot jump. Is it not? We have to follow. We have to go to the all stages of bhakti. So Srila Goswami is explaining, when we develop the taste for the holy name, we get the glimpse of attachment. We are very, very near to the attachment. But that taste for the holy name, which is called lobha or ruchi, it will come only when we have done, when we have followed the process of sadhana bhakti very seriously, and by the mercy of the Guru and Vaishnavas, by mercy of the devotees who are chanting the pure holy name, Shuddhana, by their mercy, we may reach the stage of ruchi. And that is the beginning, when we are able to start, when we reach the stage of the ruchi, lobha. That is why Sri Rupa Goswami says, Krishna bhakti rasa bhavita mati kriyata yat kudho vilabhyate tatrapi lolyam ekalam mulam koti janma sukriti na labhyate. So that lobh, that greed, it is not just ordinary greed. So of course in English we have to use the two words, intense greed. But actually there is one word which is lolya, lobh. That lobh has to, we have to read that stage of lobh at least. That lobh. Lolyam ekalam mulyam. So that price is what? And Sri Rupa Goswami, so Prabhupada has translated, he says that do not bargain. Do not bargain, purchase it without delay, wherever it is available. And this is available here in Navadvip Dham, in the Association of Devotees. Why? You'll ask why. Because here we are actually doing this parikrama in the Association of Devotees. In the Association of the Pranay Bhakta, what Bhaktivinoda Thakur says? Gaura Mars, Jesab Sthane, Karolo Brahman Range. Isn't that Bhaktivinoda Thakur is saying? Se Sab Sthan, Heri Vo Ami, Pranay Bhakta Sange. I will see all the places of pastimes of Lord Chaitanya and Navadvip. How? In the Association of Devotees who are Pranay Bhakta, who have got deep attachment for the Lord, who have got deep attachment for the holy name, for the pastimes of the Lord, who are able to remember the Lord, in their association when I go in Navadvip and do the parikrama, I will be able to remember the Lord. So it is not just walking, morning walk or noon walk or evening walk we are doing in Navadvip. So we are doing this with the hearing and chanting. The hearing and chanting is the most powerful limb of devotional service. The parikrama becomes powerful when we hear and chant the holy names of the Lord. Then only parikrama is complete. Otherwise, not complete. It's not just walking. We are not going for a morning walk. Is it not? So we have to remember that when we are doing parikrama, if we are not hearing and chanting, we are not going to get the full benefit. That's why Srila Ji Goswami has said in Bhakti-sandarbha, each limb of bhakti must be accompanied by the chanting of the holy name of the Lord. Because in Kali Yuga, other limbs of bhakti, they are not as powerful as the holy names of the Lord. So therefore, what does it mean? It means that each limb of bhakti must be accompanied by the holy name of the Lord. Because then only we will be able to remember the Lord. So in the poem, there is one poem written by Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Thakur, very famous poem, Vaishnav Ke. So in that Vaishnav Ke, he says that how we will be able to remember the Lord. He said, by the power of kirtan. Kirtana prabhave, he says, kirtana prabhave. By the prabhava of kirtan, by the prabhava of sankirtan, what will happen? Hoive swaran. He says, we'll be able to remember the Lord by the power of kirtan. So we are able to do kirtan throughout the whole life. And what will happen? Because of that power of the sankirtan, by the power of the harinam, which we have been doing through the whole life, what will happen? We will be able to remember the Lord. Therefore, kirtan is very important. Chanting of the Lord, a lot of the very important. That's why Srila Prabhupada stresses on preaching. That is the reason. Because if you don't preach, it will be very, very difficult, almost impossible to remember the Lord at the end of the life. Therefore, we have to keep on preaching. Preaching is so nice that preaching gives you the opportunity not to do prajalpa. Preaching gives you the opportunity not to offend the Vaishnavas. Preaching gives you the opportunity not to criticize the devotees. Preaching gives you the opportunity to glorify the Lord. Preaching gives you the opportunity to remember the Lord. Because you are always preaching. Preaching means you are not going to do prajalpa with the new people when you are preaching, is it not? We are not going to do that. When we go outside to preach, we are not going to do prajalpa. We are not going to talk about the devotees, you know. There, we will be preaching. That is the focus. So if you keep on doing that, every day go out for Harinam, every day go for book distribution, every day go and serve prasadam, distribute prasadam, what will happen? At the end of the life, there will be the effect. Whatever you have done the whole life, there will be effect of that. And the effect will be at the end of the life, even if you are not able to remember the Lord because of any health situation, bad health situation, that time the Lord will see, oh, this devotee has been serving me for the whole life. Hearing and chanting, he has been trying. There is something which is lacking. Okay, what I can do is, I have this complete. No problem. 95%, 5% I will give him. Bonus, we will get bonus. This is called the bonus points. We will get 5% by the mercy of the Supreme Lord. Lord Chaitanya is so merciful. And we have seen in our movement, many devotees who have left. They left the body. Many, many devotees. Like Jayananda Prabhu. His grace, Jayananda Prabhu. One of the examples I'm just giving, there are many devotees like that. But Jayananda Prabhu, at the end of the life, when he had got blood cancer, leukemia, and there was an arrangement, the government was giving aid, you know, he got some $5,000. And $5,000, he said, what will I do? I'm going to leave. So he wanted to give to Srila Prabhupada. He said, Prabhupada, you can take this, you can use it for preaching. So Prabhupada was so happy at the end of the life, he's not worried about his body. He's not worried about cancer. Leukemia, blood cancer, last stage. And so Srila Prabhupada was almost in tears. And you see, this is a sign of a pure devotee. This is a sign how he must so much surrender he is. And then what happened? So the doctor said, you know, better take him back. You take him and serve him there. So no need to keep him in the hospital. So he came back. And what I heard is that during the Mangalarti, as a conch blow for the Mangalarti, at that time he was hearing Shat Goswami has to come in his room. Srila Prabhupada, Shat Goswami has to come. And the conch blew and he was hearing Shat Goswami has to come sung by Srila Prabhupada and he left the body. So like that, there are many, many devotees who left the body like that and remember the Lord at the end of their life. They had a very, very serious health issues, but somehow the Lord arranged for them. Even we were talking about His Grace Buddhimanta Prabhu, who was a very book distributor. And so he left the body in Vrindavan. I remember, I don't remember the year exactly, maybe 93 or 94 somewhere. So in Vrindavan temple, he left the body there. And like that, many devotees, His Grace Aindra Prabhu, he left the body in Vrindavan Dham. And when they opened the door, as soon as they opened the door, that's what they saw. Aindra Prabhu was paying obeisance. He had was paying obeisances to Nityananda Prabhu. And that's how he left the body. So the Lord arranges. So Lord arranges like that. So what we have to do is, we have to do your duty. Like for us, somebody asked Prabhupada, Prabhupada is there in the morning walk. He said, one of the devotees said, Prabhupada, actually, if we have been so sinful, we have committed so many sinful activity, and now we have come to devotional service, it will be possible for us to remember the Lord at the end of the life? Srila Prabhupada immediately answered. He didn't take anyone single second to answer that. He immediately answered. Srila Prabhupada said, that is guaranteed. Prabhupada said, that is guaranteed. But then, second line is also very important. Prabhupada said, but you have to do your duties properly. That Prabhupada said, he said, you have to do your duties properly. So we do our duties properly, that arrangement is made. That is guaranteed. Srila Prabhupada is guaranteed. If we do our duties, follow, duties mean we follow the duty, spiritual duty, follow the process of bhakti and serve the mission of Lord Chaitanya. So that's how, even once Srila Prabhupada in Los Angeles, so he was saying, if you chant 16 rounds without offenses, follow the four regular day principles, serve the Vaishnavas, serve the mission of Lord Chaitanya, you will go back home, back to Godhead. Prabhupada said. So he told that Jayadvaita Swami Maharaj was sitting next to him, and after the class he asked, Srila Prabhupada, is it so easy? Is it so easy to remember the Lord? By just following the simple process, chanting Hare Krishna 16 rounds, following four regulative principles, and serving the mission of Lord Chaitanya, serving the mission of serving the Vaishnavas, is it that easy? And Prabhupada hit the table like this, and he said, yes, you just follow this process, simple process, and you will see Krishna face to face in this lifetime itself. So the mercy is always there, but the point is that, see, suppose somebody like Prabhupada in one place, you know, he was Sulana Chapataka Swami Maharaj saying, so Prabhupada is a Vyasasar. So somebody asked Prabhupada, how much purity we need to remember the Lord and to go back home, back order? Prabhupada said, 100% purity is required. And devotees got discouraged. 100% purity, we don't have 100% purity. And Prabhupada said, devotees are getting discouraged. And then Prabhupada said, 90% purity is okay. And still devotees were not so, you know, convinced, you know. And then he was getting down from the Vyasas, and then he finally said, 70% is enough. And put the chadar, put the shawl like this. He said, 70% purity is enough. So, and the Jai Srila Prabhupada, everybody said. You're not saying Jai Srila Prabhupada. And then, you know, when he got down, and the point is, when we Prabhupada is saying 70%, that doesn't mean we should try only for 70%. Just like in the school or the college, when you actually appear for the exam, you know, and you may have a desire to, you know, top the university or to top the college, and that is the goal. That should be the goal for all the students, is it not? We want to get full marks. So we have to try for 100%, and then if you are not able to do that 100%, we may get 70%, is it not? So that means we follow the process of bhakti 100%, and if it comes down to 70% for some reason, then that mercy will flow. Is it not? We try only for 70%. Just like somebody will say, I just want to try to clear the exam. But there may be possibility we may even fail. So we have to try for 100%, then, you know, we may get some, you know, bonus. Okay, 100%, he was trying at least for 100%. Okay, he reached to the level of 70%. Okay, Hari Bol. So like that. And then, you know, what happened? In one time, they asked Srila Prabhupada, Prabhupada, your Guru Maharaj was very, very strict. And then, you know, you are so merciful. And so we will be able to go to the spiritual world. Is it that easy? Prabhupada said, yeah, my Guru Maharaj has got the front door key and I've got the back door key. have the back door key. If they are not allowed from the front door, I'll make sure that devotees can go from the back door. So like that. So mercy is always there with us. Mercy is always flowing. It depends about us. It depends upon us that how much we are ready to accept that mercy. Mercy is always flowing. Sometimes I say to the devotees, to the seniors, Prabhuji, please bestow mercy on us. So mercy is always there, provided we are ready to accept that mercy. So where we are come to hear and chant, and we hear and chant nicely, what will happen when we go back to our places, our temples, what will happen? We'll be able to remember the Lord. So therefore, in Srimad Bhagavatam, it's also said, after hearing Srimad Bhagavatam or after chanting, what we should do is, we should also contemplate. Contemplation is very, very important. After hearing Srimad Bhagavatam, what happens? Generally what happens? We go to Srimad Bhagavatam in a very passive state, you know. And just like in the school, you know, teachers used to say, okay, tomorrow we'll have this class, so this is the homework, and go and study this chapter. Go back home and study this chapter, is it not? So next day, the students are very active, they already know something. So there is a possibility they will ask a lot of questions. But what happens, you know, generally what happens? We go to Srimad Bhagavatam class, we go for hearing, and with a passive state, we have not heard anything about the words, we have not read even that chapter, and then go and sit, and then we are in a passive state. After some time, we are in a sleeping mode. I start, you know, closing. But if we actually prepare ourselves, we see that verse, what is the verse will be taken tomorrow, we read the purport, make some notes, and then attend the classes next day, what will happen? We will be able to grasp more, and then there's a possibility we may ask questions also and discuss also. And then after that, we have heard the lecture. What we are supposed to do is that when we go back to our rooms, we should again contemplate what we have heard, what we heard. And when we hear that, what will happen? Then there will be remembrance. So there is a way to practice this Smaranam. But point is that the powerful process, the hearing, the chanting of the holy name of the Lord, the kirtan, the more we do kirtan here, the more we chant the holy names of the Lord, in the dham is so powerful. Like in Braj, you know, when we go to Braj, they say that if you chant one round, it's equal to 1,000 rounds. You know, so it's like that. In Navadwip, it's also like when we chant, Gauranga!
Gauranga!
One name of Gauranga, 1,000 times you have already chanted. It's so nice. So why won't we take advantage of Navadwip dham? Why we are in inactive state? Let us chant more and more, more and more. Let us develop that greed. We have so many nice, wonderful Vaishnavas here. Let us be very, very close to them. Is it not? Let us go near to them. Try to take association. And then what will happen, we'll be able to remember the Lord. Hare Krishna. Srila Prabhupada.
Thank you very, very much, Mahendra Prabhu. Mahendra touched on an interesting point I wanted to tell you.
Thank you for watching our videos. Be sure to subscribe to our channel. We publish new videos every day, and don't forget to like and share our channel.